Hey guys, so today on Lichess, we're going to be using Lichess again, and this time we're going to be talking about the concept of castling. We talked about it when we were talking about how the kings move, but and the rooks, but I mean, now we're going to like do like a whole video based on it. So yeah, let's begin. So if you remember, you cannot castle on your first move because of these two. So you're gonna have to make some moves first. I can show you the quickest way. See, you castle on move 4. Yeah, well, that's that. That's how you castle on move 4. But here's how it would normally go. It's like this. Oh, it's off my bed. No. Normally it's like this. Attack. This. And then this. Yeah, this is how it would normally be, and then use a castle, and then yeah, however you want to play it next, you can play it like that. So yeah, that's that. Wait. Okay, don't mind that stuff, you don't need to mind that, okay? So the regular way to castle is e4. E5, we'll learn the notations later. Normally, I would like sus play this instantly. I guess. Actually, I don't know what I would play. If this. Okay, never mind. You don't need to. So, I mean, you understand how to castle, right? See, once you're. Look. I'll show you the main thing. So, see how your king has to go like this? But see, at the beginning, these two pieces, the bishop and the knight, they are stuck. They're in the middle of your king and your rook. See? These two. They're in the middle. They can't pass. See? Yeah. And because of that, first, just before you can castle, you have to get these two out. See? We've already gotten them out. You see, now, because you got both of these pieces out, you moved the bishop here and the knight here. Because you did that, now, it frees up this. Oh, it's up my bed. It frees up these two squares, then your king can go here and your rook can go here, since they have moved to these squares. See? And now you can just castle and second dock. Simple. Yeah, so see? So, before you can castle, you always need to get these two out of here by playing this, this, this. You can bring your bishop out. You bring your bishop out. And once you get these two pieces out, here, you could even bring them out here or here, wherever you want, as long as it's not hanging. Like, that means they can castle it. As long as they can't capture, it's good, and you can castle on the next move, once you remove these two from these two squares. And yeah, that's how you castle. Well guys, that's the end of this episode. I hope you enjoyed learning how what you have to do to castle. So to review, you have to get your bishop and knight out. The best is where nothing can capture them. And once the two pieces are out, the other squares, you can castle. But try to make sure they're not hanging. Otherwise, you're gonna lose material. We're going to talk about like what hanging means. later. Well, guys, so yeah, that's kind of this episode. I really hope you enjoyed learning what you have to do in order to be able to castle, remove your knight and bishop, and oh, stop! There's something I forgot to cover. So, you see how the here on the king is closer to this rook and the queen's closer to this rook? Well, there's something called kingside castling and queenside castling. Kingside castling is not. I'm gonna just okay. Kingside castling is when you castle with the rook that is closer to your king, this rook. And queenside castling is when you castle with the rook that is further from your king and closer to your queen. See? 1, 2. And here it's 1, 2. So, and then see, your king has to move 2 squares here. So see, in kingside castling, if this was kingside, your king would be here. But because it's queenside, it's further since your king only moves 2. Your king is here, not here. Also, this doesn't work. I just did that for fun. Okay, well guys, so yeah, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed also learning about what kingside castling and queenside castling is. And well, that's it for castling and learning what castling is and how to castle. What you have to do first, you remove your knight and bishop for kingside and queen knight and bishop for queenside. Also, it has to be these two. For queenside, you have to remove these 3, and for kingside, you have to remove these 2. Okay, well guys, so that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed learning how to castle, what's kingside castling and queenside castling, and what you have to do in order to castle. Well, that's it for castling, what you have to do and how to do it, what's queenside and kingside, and until next time, bye bye guys!